scripture, is it found that the church has the right to interpret scripture? The simple answer to this question is just a historical fact. The church existed before the Bible, as we find it today, as Christians. The New Testament was written by the church. The New Testament was written for the church. And the New Testament was written about the church. If that is true, then obviously the community that birthed it about itself and to itself is the one that has the right to interpret it. That is a historical fact. The church, therefore, does not need or require any authority from Scripture to interpret a book that it wrote to itself about itself.
Can I come back on that point?
No, because I'm debating Hashim. Your second point was about Athanasius. As Christians, we don't deny, or have ever denied, that the church has been interpreting its text and has been writing about its beliefs. Muslims have been doing the same.
Oh, does that make it right?
So,
does that make it okay?
If you'll stop heckling for a second, that would be great. That would be great.
You have to
heckling, heckling, heckling. Please note how the Islamic Dawah team behaves. The church,
that is Christian.
He's not a Christian. The church has the right. The church has the right to speak about its own beliefs. And yes, I believe Athanasian had the right to write a creed, and because it was accepted by the church, it is acceptable to me. No, Hashim asked the question.
Yes.
It's fair, answer it. He said, where did Jesus call himself God?
No, I asked you, where did the Holy Spirit call the Father God?
You did ask me.
I did ask, but I also asked.
Call himself God?
Yes.
I'll show you.
Where he came to be God, go on.
I'll show you using Islamic divine names.
Oh, I see.
In Surah 24, Ayah 35, it says, and I quote, Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth. In John chapter 8, verse 12, Jesus says, I am the light. Now, Hashim.
Light of what?
I am the light of the world.
Only the world?
No.
Only the world. Hashim, no heaven.
According to your Quran, who is the light of the world?
Okay.
Answer me.
Heaven.
According to the Quran, who is the light of the world?
Okay. By the way, Allah says in the Quran, it says here in Surah 435. Is that the one you quoted?
Surah 24:35.
Oh, 24. Okay, let me go to that verse. So Jesus is only the God of the world. Remember this. Yes? By the way, according to the Bible, who is the Lord of the earth? The Shaitan, the devil. Do you believe that, Bob?
He is the Lord of this realm, yes.
Okay, so he's the Lord of the world. Yes, and Jesus is the light of the world. What is Allah? Allah is the God of the Shaitan. Allah is the God of the heavens and the earth. Now who's mightier? The Shaitan, who is the Lord of the world, or the one who is the light of the world, which is Jesus? And he, by the way, Jesus is also the curse of the world. He came as a curse for you. Yes? So do not compare Allah to Jesus. Trust me, that is like bringing a gun to a knife fight. Right?
Any more? Knives.
Yeah, but I'm pretty good with a gun, trust me.
I'm pretty good with knives.
Okay, go on. By the way, toy guns.
Okay. So
are you going to answer the question? Where in the Bible did the Holy Spirit ever call God the Father God?
To my knowledge, the Holy Spirit never calls the Father God.
But Jesus called the Father God?
Yes.
So what does that tell you? Who is the only member in the Trinity who called somebody else a God?
No,
that is
your
what?
Logic, your
that
logic,
is Jesus.
Logic,
what is logic?
Is totally
I'm using
flawed.
Logic if you understood
your
basic.
Logic is totally flawed.
If you understood basic
your
knowledge.
Logic is totally flawed.
Okay, how is it flawed when your God called
your
somebody else a God?
Logic is totally flawed.
Explain how.
So,
I can explain how.
You're making an argument from silence. An argument
no, it's
from
not.
Silence
it's not an argument
works.
From silence.
I'm sorry.
It's not.
Arguments from silence do not prove anything. The evidence of absence is not absent. Is not. Sorry. The absence of evidence is not evidence of absence.
But we have evidence.
This is
Jesus called his Father God.
in rhetoric.
We do have
and
evidence.
Philosophy.
I'm sorry, we do
the
have evidence.
The idea that the Holy Spirit never called the Father God somehow breaks up the Trinity is completely illogical. You're making an argument from silence.
No, it's
it
not. It's not.
Follow.
The important thing is that
now,
Jesus is not called the Father God.
Hold on,
it's
second.
Not an absence of evidence. It
one
actually
second.
Is evidence.
1 second.
You know, there is a bit he doesn't like, that's why he doesn't want to explain it.
No.
The bit in John 2017. John 2017 has gotten confused.
Your question
and
directly.
He goes and uses words which he knows do not make sense in this context when Jesus himself calls Almighty God God. Because God doesn't have a God, John. But
no,
you need to
friend,
understand this.
My friend, you're totally wrong.
God doesn't have a God. I'm not wrong. Yes,
right. He used the idea. Notice, he didn't actually answer my question.
Which one?
I asked him.
Which one?
According to the Quran.
Yes.
Who is the light of the world? He didn't answer that.
I did.
The Quran was
what
very
you listening
clear.
To?
The Quran was very clear. Allah is the light of the world.
Not the world only.
The gospel
you see what
John, Jesus is very clear. He is the light of the world.
He's also the Quran.
Here's another comparison. In Surah 20,
I answered
Ayah 114, it reads, high above all is Allah, the King and the Truth. However, in 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 15, starting from verse 14, and you keep the commandment without stain or reproach until the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he will bring about at the proper time. He who is the blessed and the only sovereign, the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Paul, through the Holy Spirit, is declaring that Jesus is King of kings. That means he is the King of your king. He is the King of whichever king you want to uplift.
Okay.
Allah is the only sovereign according
guys,
to the
guys,
Quran.
Guys, we'll answer that, don't we?
Jesus is the only sovereign according to the Bible.
Okay.
So according to the Bible, Jesus is God. Thank you very much.
Okay, let's see this what the Bible says, which you missed out clearly, is this. Jesus says in Acts chapter 3, verse 13, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of our fathers, has raised his servant, Jesus. So your King of kings is a servant of my God. Thank you very much. That is from the Bible. Wait, wait, I haven't finished yet, Bob. And also Jesus says, and also Jesus says in chapter 5, verse 30, that I by myself can do nothing. Yes, this is another verse in the Bible where Jesus is nothing according to your own Bible. Shall I bring up more verses where Jesus, wait, I will finish. Oh, no, no, I only made two statements. Hold on. You made much more statements and you're not worried that I'm actually exposing you.
It's not worried.
I don't want to forget them all. Why you want me to stop?
I don't want to forget them all.
Write it down then. You look worried actually.
Not
okay.
Worried.
By the way, he only admitted to us that Jesus is a curse of the world, and Jesus, according to the Shaitan or the Satan or the devil, yes, Lucifer, like you would know, so called, is actually the God of the world. Is the God of the world, the Lord of the world. So your King of Kings is not the Lord of the world. Who is the Lord of the world according to the Bible? The devil. Yes, the enemy of God has taken over. According to the Bible, taking over sovereignty of the world for some reason. Unless your Bible is lying, then saying he's not actually the Lord of the world, but they still call him Lord of the world.
Are you done now, Hashim?
And Jesus is called the curse.
Are you done now?
Yeah, gone.
So,
he got worried there.
Hashim jumps around the Bible worse than a Jehovah's Witness. Every time you show him a verse that he finds difficult,
Adam-ness.
He simply skips to another verse.
I thought you had the Bible.
He showed a verse showing that Jesus was a servant.
Yes.
I agree.
Yes.
But let me explain to him.
Bigger hole.
Because the Bible gives him an answer.
Yes.
And if he wasn't working from such a strict script, he might have actually engaged with it.
It's a Bible, by the way.
So, in Philippians chapter 2, verse 3, do nothing from selfishness or empty conceit, but with humility of mind, regard one another as more important than yourselves. Do not merely look out for your own personal interests, but also of the interests of others. Have this attitude in yourselves, which was also in Christ Jesus, who, although he existed in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped.
Did not, yes. You're right.
But emptied himself, taking the form of a bondservant. So the Bible says that Christ had the equality of God, was in the form of God, but humbled himself as a servant.
Emptied, emptied.
So you quoting verses showing that Jesus was a servant doesn't disprove my faith. It only confirms it, because it is the fullness of Scripture that has to be allowed to speak, not simply taking verses out of context like you are attempting to do.
No, I'm not.
No.
It's not an
Hadouken.
It's not a Hadouken. Actually,
no, one second.
Can I respond to that?
Sorry, one second.
Now you're pushing.
No, no. One second. Points. You made a number of points.
I made 2 points.
You made
actually,
a number of points.
He did not bring
he's worried
up.
Now.
I'm not worried.
Worried.
No, no. I want to show
he's
you.
Worried.
I want to show you where you're wrong.
He's worried. No. Let's just find it.
By the way,
in,
an empty God, he said, yeah?
In Surah 57, Ayah 3, Allah takes on two names for himself, Al-Awwal and Al-Akiyah.
Oh.
Again, apologies if I'm slaughtering the Arabic.
Al-Awwal
and Al-Akiyah. These are, I am the first and the last.
Yeah.
Jesus describes himself as the first and the last. How many different ways do you want me to show you, Hashim? Jesus called himself God, yes. Your God. Why can you not accept the evidence?
Sorry.
These are clear statements. You've got to deal with them. I want you to deal with them.
I will not
deal with them. I want you to jump around to
no,
other verses.
No, I will jump around
Jesus
the verses
said,
I want, don't worry.
Jesus said, I am
worried.
The first and I am the last.
Yes.
In the Quran.
Okay.
Allah says,
by,
I am the first
by the way,
and I am the last.
Bob, you're
Jesus is calling himself God.
I heard it 3 times, man. Come on, stop repeating yourself. Okay, Bob here said he emptied himself. So Jesus was an empty God or fully God?
You're not answering my
it's
question.
It's a cross question, remember?
Okay, so until Hashim starts answering my questions, at this point I'm not going to answer any more of his.
Okay,
answer my question.
Looks like he's worried now.
Answer the question.
You see, this is the kind of conversation I wanted to have, where we ask a question and a response, not giving 5 minutes and give me 5 minutes.
You didn't answer.
Which one?
Answer the question.
Jesus says, I am the first, I am the last. Allah says, I am the first, I am the last.
Yes, that was the second question, right?
That point.
That was the second point. I'm still with the first point that you made from was it Corinthians? Which one was it? No, Philippians. Philippians. That is the one I'm addressing. You said Jesus emptied himself.
In the form of God.
Yes, so he's an empty God, right?
No, not in this sense.
So is it
emptying himself?
Means what?
It means it's talking about the qualities, removing those qualities that
which
would prevent him becoming human.
No, no, which are the qualities that were removed from him?
The qualities, it's a good question actually.
Thank you.
And it might address something that Hashim likes to quote and address all of these verses that show Christ's humanity.
Please do.
Notice he goes to verses that show that Christ had limited knowledge, that Christ needed to rest, that Christ needed to eat, and he uses them as proofs that Christ isn't God. When actually, all they are proofs that Christ took on the fullness of humanity. Now, for God to do this, he had to empty himself of something.
Of what?
He had to take off some of the properties of divinity.
Which is?
Such as not needing food, such as complete knowledge of all things.
Okay.
He took these things off. These do not make God God. They are like robes to God. They are like clothes to God. He takes them off.
So you're telling
and
me.
And enters into humanity.
So you're telling me.
I
that
am.
He,
let me finish.
Oh, you're still answering.
Let
go on.
Me finish.
Go on, go on.
Yeah. But you're going to address my question.
I will. No problem at all.
Thank you.
I will.
In the same way that when H2O becomes ice or becomes gas or becomes liquid,
yeah,
it changes its form without changing its essence. Christ emptied himself of those things that would prevent him taking on the fullness of humanity and took on the fullness of humanity.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean that he stopped being God.
So this
and
God
this is not what the
saying. So wait a minute, you're telling me that here.
Now address my second.
No, wait a minute.
He doesn't want to address the I am
Bob,
the first.
Bob, do you remember
statement.
This was the first question?
Are you going to address
it? I will.
No,
I will. After this.
I will know.
After
I want you to address it
let
now.
Let me finish this point.
Address it now, Hashim.
I don't go according to you.
Hashim.
I don't go according to you.
Hashim, you're not here to
over here.
This debate.
That's fine. You're afraid that I will bring up this point. This will destroy you. This will destroy you.
You don't want to
address
the point.
point I want to make. I've already told you I'm going to address it.
Okay.
But I want this to be. I want to make a point here.
Yeah.
You said he actually did not have these qualities. Where God Almighty, my Allah, doesn't need to eat. But he's saying his God has left this attribute where he doesn't need to eat. So now you've got one less attribute. Another attribute that was less in him is of knowledge. So he's not all knowledgeable. My God Almighty is all knowledgeable. His God wasn't all knowledgeable. That's why he claims that he's ignorant of the hour. But look, this same Paul, who is the one who wrote Philippians, I believe.
Yes.
Yes. Says what? In Colossians chapter 2, verse 9. And this is what he says. For in Christ, all the fullness of the deity lives in bodily form.
Yes.
Yes, Paul?
Yes.
Sorry, Bob. And this is what Paul says. For in Christ, all the fullness of the deity lives in bodily form.
Yes.
And in Christ, you have been brought to fullness. So either Paul is saying he's emptied himself, or he's contradicting himself, in other words, where he's fully God in bodily form. How do you tend to you both? Carry on.
No, that was very funny. However, what it does is it demonstrates why.
What?
The fundamental premise of Hashim's argument is based on the idea that divinity is connected to the attributes of God. Yeah. That it is the attributes of God that define what God is. No, they don't. The attributes of God only define how we experience God. They define a philosophical language with which we talk about God. They don't make what God is. Essence of God is not his attributes. The attributes flow from his essence. They are things that don't define his divinity. The fullness of divinity, the fullness of the essence, theosis, entered into a union with a human nature. The attributes obviously became limited. In doing so, that's the logical outflowing of this position. But I notice Hashim, even though promising he was going to address my point, hasn't done so.
I said I will.
Has not done so.
I said I will. After this point, Hashim, I will.
The point no, 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 wait 1 second, Hashim.
Oh, you don't want me to address the point now?
1 second, Hashim.
By the way, point one says he's emptied himself, and another says fullness of the deity lives in him.
No, Hashim.
This is a clear contradiction.
No, Hashim.
We will not fall for the word gymnastics which you have just done.
I'm sorry,
unfortunately,
Hashim.
You cannot hide anymore. He's either fully God or he's an empty God. Make up your mind. Because Paul couldn't make up his mind. Paul couldn't make up his mind.
Unfortunately, Hashim.
What?
Hashim is trying to base his argument on a premise that is false.
Which is the Bible.
His argument
this
makes
is the Bible.
Only one sense. Only
thank
makes
you.
Sense if the what is being discussed by Paul
yes.
is understood that God is defined by his attributes. This premise I disagree with. You can't prove your premise, so it is a non-argument.
So God is not defined by his attributes?
No.
So you're saying any Tom, Dick, and Harry can come and say I'm God, and they're God. Wow, this is really great. Because in the Bible,
Hashim,
Jesus
is dealing with the fact
what?
That in Allah, Allah gives himself divine names.
I will come to that.
Christ
nobody.
Claims those
nobody.
Divine
no,
names.
No, Christ doesn't claim
he
that.
Doesn't
Christ gave
you the evidence.
Hold on.
Very clearly where Jesus calls himself
I gave you the evidence.
By the names
look,
of your God. I'll give you another one.
Let me address that.
No, I'll give you another
one. You know what
I'll give you another
one. The guy was crying to give him address the point. Now he doesn't want me to address
so,
it.
So,
make up your mind. Just like Paul, you can't make up your mind either.
No, unfortunately,
fully God, empty God, make up your mind.
Characterizations don't deal with the point that I'm making.
Actually, it is a Bible I quoted. It wasn't my script.
You're trying to jump
it
around.
It was a Bible.
Because you're
I'm not jumping around.
To deal with the points that
look,
I'm making.
Look, you're Bob, now you've been cornered like a disease, so you want to move on. Carry on. By the way, do you want me to address the Alpha and Omega or not?
Yes, please.
Okay,
please
good.
Address that
good.
Point.
Because now we have moved on from the empty God or fully God, so we're moving on to the point that I said I will come back to. By the way, Jesus, if he is the Alpha and Omega, then we have another being called Melchizedek, who said, I have no beginning of days, no end of life, no mother, no father, no genealogy. He is the likeness of the Son of God. Remember, likeness of the Son of God. So Bob, if you're in the likeness of your daddy, you are not your daddy. You are in his likeness. So anyone who claims that this is a pre-Jesus or you probably know the terminology. This is not Jesus Christ coming before his incarnation. This is him saying that he has no beginning of days, no end of time. So if you believe that Anyone who calls themselves the Alpha and Omega is God, then why do we not see Jesus, believers, or Christian believers, or Christians, ever worshipping the Melchizedek, the man of mystery, the man who had no mother, no father, no genealogy, no beginning of days, and no end of time? This is in Hebrews chapter 7, verse 3, which later on he says he will send another in his place, or something of that effect. I forget the exact words, but we can find out.
Okay, so Hashim didn't actually answer my question.
I did.
About Christ using divine titles and calling himself God.
Yeah.
All he did is skip to another verse of the Bible to throw out his parrot-fashion set of basic polemics.
Yeah.
And this is Hashim's style. I get that.
He doesn't like the Bible for some reason.
I get that.
He doesn't like the Bible.
I will address his point when he starts to address mine.
I did
what
address.
I would like to bring up here is yet another example.
I saw the example of
ignorant. Jesus
and
calls himself
ignorant.
God.
Ignorant.
So, in Surah 30, I think it's 31 actually.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go 31, 30.
Because Allah's name is not the servant. Jesus calls himself the servant.
We've already addressed this.
No, you haven't. You said that he emptied himself, and I showed you another verse.
So,
that is fully God.
He is basically avoiding the fact of dealing with the fact
I did
that
already.
Jesus
you don't like my answers.
The names of Allah very plainly to call himself God. Or more rather, Allah is stealing the divine names of Jesus to call himself God.
Allah never calls himself the servant. Never calls himself the servant.
The divine names of Jesus to refer to.
Did he say he's an empty God? No. Did he say he died for my salvation? No. These are one of the names of Allah is I, the ever living. Did Jesus die?
Is the only truth.
Who's the only truth?
Allah, according to your Quran.
Yes.
So Jesus says.
What?
In John 14, verse 6, I am the way and the truth. So tell me, Hashim.
Yes.
Is Jesus the truth or is Allah the truth?
Okay, when you say
is
that.
Is Jesus the first and the last or is Allah the first and the last?
Okay, first.
Is Jesus the light of the world or is Allah the light of the world? Please address this point.
I've already addressed them, but you don't like my answers, unfortunately. I've already said, if you want to believe Jesus is God, because he's the Alpha and Omega, then you should be consistent and not use double standards by worshipping Melchizedek as God, because he's better than Jesus. Jesus at least had a mother. Melchizedek had no mother, no father. Jesus, according to the Bible, had two genealogies. How many? Two genealogies. How many genealogies? Guess what? Melchizedek had none. Melchizedek had no beginning of days, no end of time. If that is not Alpha and Omega, I don't know what is. So Melchizedek had better qualities, better attributes than that of Jesus. Are you going to worship him, Bob the Builder? Or you're going to say, no, you're basically avoiding my question. I'm not. I'm saying be consistent. If you're going to use this argument as your basis for worshipping Jesus as God, then be consistent and worship Melchizedek.
Unfortunately, I can't take lectures in consistency from Hashim. The man creates double standards all the time.
We like
I have asked him repeatedly to address the point about the divine names that Allah stole from Jesus to call himself the light of the world, the first and the last, the resurrection, the truth, the king, the sovereign. All of these are the titles that Jesus uses to refer to himself very plainly and thus calling himself God. But unlike Hashim, he will address I went away and I looked into it more. I was wrong. So I'm correcting myself. The reference that Paul makes to Melchizedek is about the difference between Melchizedek as a priest and the Levitical priesthood. To enter into the Levitical priesthood, your chain, your family chain, both mother and father, were traced so that you could be proven to